gonna be late grand final, so please completely clear the field. Thank you. Sterling NT, head up higher, Intersport, and to all our media partners, in Darwin, the NT News, News 949, and Hot 100. Good afternoon, and if we're only just welcoming you to TIO, we are here for the NTFL Women's Grand Final Day. It's already been a massive morning with the under-15s. Girls Grand Final a little bit earlier, St. Mary's taking out the win over Wanderers. And then the game we just witnessed, the under-18s with the Darwin Buffets taking it out over Palmerston Magpies. We still have one more very big game to go. So we'd like to thank everyone for coming along today. Firstly, if you don't know me, my name is Sarah, and it's been really exciting to have Hot 100 involved throughout the whole season of the NTFL, and then again today. At halftime, we will have the Hot 100 halftime sprint. That one is going to be a mix of fun. Now, the umpires have just walked onto the field, so I think it's about time we welcome our teams here for the Women's Premier League Grand Final. don't go anywhere. After the women's grand final, it'll be the men's Premier League prelim final with the Southern Districts and TIO Bombers. So that will kick off at 7 p.m. tonight. Still plenty to happen here at TIO Stadium. But you've been waiting all afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, the players and the umpires will now link arms on the playing arena to say no more to domestic violence.
More than 80 Australian women and men were killed last year by family violence. The No More campaign uses the power of sport to change the way the public views family violence. The linking of arms is a symbolic statement to show that everyone who links up is committed to ending the violence, no matter where or who they are. When these players link arms today, they're raising awareness about the issue and sending a strong message to everyone that family violence is never acceptable. Today, we congratulate both teams on taking a stand against family and domestic violence. Sign up to show your support at nomore.org.au.
I would now like to welcome Larrakia woman Billawarra Lee into the arena for our Welcome to Country.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Gulmanda, Larrakia Lee. My name is Auntie Billawarra, or you call me Auntie B, which is easier. I am a member of the large extended Tubillow family. I also have a hard look when I'm asked to do a welcome, and I don't know if you realise it, but when you ask the traditional owner to do a welcome, you show respect to the First Nation peoples of the land and their ancestors. And I accept your respect. Thank you. I give a special welcome to our elders who are here today, also to family and friends, but especially to my brothers and sisters from other First Nations. A welcome from my heart. I recognise the strength of spirit and depth of knowledge that exists in both the elders of the past and present, and I know the rich tapestry of the dreaming still runs strong in mind, body and spirit. Australian Aboriginal culture is the oldest indigenous culture on earth. And to me, a welcome to country is about acknowledging the past and looking to the future. Spiritually, I'm honouring the presence of my ancestors, whose ancient energy flows through all creation. And my traditional country covers the land and waters of the Great Darwin region. And although our lands extend up 50 kilometres inland, we are known as saltwater people. I feel really blessed to be here today to do this welcome before the Women's AFL Premier League final. Because when I was a young girl, I wasn't allowed to play football, you know, except in the backyard with my many brothers. And I'm loving the choices that women and young girls have today. And I think sport can play a very important role in bringing about change. I want to wish you all a happy International Women's Day. And we are all standing on the shoulders of strong, resilient ancestors who fought and struggled to make our world a better place. Please walk proudly in their footsteps and strive to make our legacy known that every single student is proud of. Gender balance is essential for economies and communities to survive. Let's work together to build a gender balanced world, and everyone has a part to play all the time, everywhere. So it is on that note, it is my privilege on behalf of my husband's past and present to welcome you all to Waratah and to our land. Welcome to my saltwater home with great food, friendly people, beautiful beaches and spectacular sunsets. Because there are countries like a pearl within layers of different peoples of different countries living and loving in the distinctive spiritual past. And from the moment you are born here or arrived in Darwin, you have been immersed in the outfield ancestral energy. And as you walk across the land, I ask the ancestors to make your journey in my country safe and rewarding, and that they protect you while you're here. All that I ask in return is that you walk softly on Mother Earth and treat her with all the respect as an outfield can do. So
much
you are. Thank you.
Thank you for a beautiful welcome to country. All right, ladies and gentlemen, can we please have you
Hello everyone and a big welcome to TIO Stadium in Darwin. It is grand final day in the women's competition and Southern Districts take on Waratahs. Waratahs, they've won six of the last seven. What an incredible team they are, coached magnificently by Colleen Gwynn. They're not confident about this one though, because that team that you can see there, not that team, the other team, Southern Districts come into this game after a terrific win last week against Palmerston, who were expected to be playing today. They finished third this year, Southern Districts, and they think they can snatch it in this big game. All or nothing on the line today. Joining me in commentary, Ash Menakaris. Should be a good game. Ash, what do you think of it?
Yeah, I think it'll be a very interesting game here. Tars clearly have would go into this game as favourites. They've got around the ground, Charlie, that, gee, they've got some good players. Lauren O'Shea, Becky Pryor, and then Lisa Roberts, of course. And then, you know, Districts have got Letitia Jeffrey, but they are probably a bit better coached. Tarman Elliott is a very good coach and was a pretty good footballer in his day.
And the Southern Districts team, they've got a real chance here today. I agree with him. He's a good coach. So Katie Streeter joining us for the very first time. Nice to have you with us, Katie. Welcome.
Thanks, Charlie. Great to be here. And a very exciting game that we do have on our hands. I think Districts are going to go in there with so much grit and determination. They've first time they've faced finals, and I think they've got a lot to prove.
I think that's the Woomeras we're seeing there jumping around, isn't it?
Yeah, they're very excited.
Yeah, so how do they approach this game? Southern Districts, they've got to be underdogs, aren't they, surely?
Surely they are. They, with the experience that the Tars have brought to the table, yeah, this is their eighth run in the on the big stage for their grand final, and I just think that they've got the experience, the composure. But, yeah, it's great to see a game that's a little bit unpredictable, and hopefully it's going to be a nice close one.
Well, it's been a bit like that all year. They played twice, these two teams. Tars won back in round two, 9-5 to two goals, but Districts got them in round seven, beat them 2-7 to 2-2, and won by just 5 points. So it's 1-1 coming into this game. Looking back to the finals last week, Tars beat the Buffets to knock them out of the competition by 35 points. And Southern Districts, big last quarter from them, got up to get past Palmerston and won 7 goals, 9-5. Through the margin, 18 points, and they can take a lot out of that game. They finished fuller running, and I think, Ash, you were saying, Tars not that impressive in their last quarter.
No, in fact, I thought Darwin Buffaloes were a bit unlucky for the entire four quarters, but it just came down to the fact that Waratahs were a little bit more structured over the course of the four quarters. But interestingly, Charlie, in that last quarter last week, Waratahs didn't kick a goal, and I think that's not a particularly good sign going into a grand final.
Yeah, and that's where Southern Districts really stepped up in that last quarter, and I think that's what got them over the line for sure, I guess.
So Tars, 13 wins, 2 losses and a draw in the season. Their percentage, 411%. Palmerston finished second. Southern Districts finished in third position, 11 wins and 5 losses, 238%. So second best percentage in the competition behind Tars. You played for Pint. You played both these teams. Who's going to win it?
I'm going the underdog, Southern Districts.
About to get underway. Here's Ash Menakaris to get us underway.
Back in the middle, umpire Rawshorn. Maddie and Paddy Rawshorn, the two brothers. Andre of the goals is knocked away, knocked forward. Trying to sock it off the ground was Pryor. Couldn't quite pick it up. Loose. No one can get complete control. Still loose. Pryor bends over, gives a hurried handball out. Met heavily there was the Tars player. Quick kick off the ground though. District's defence trying to hold strong. Loose. Now they're trying to get it forward. And again, inside the forward line, handed over, running over it was O'Shea. And Districts will bring it out of defence, hopefully if they can get a clean kick away, and they do.
Taylor Thorne with the kick, got it out wide, ball knocked to ground there. They emerged from everywhere, handball was only okay. Tars with a hurried kick, came from goal, found a teammate right out in front of goals. Great mark taken there. Sue Nolder is going to punish them on the scoreboard. She were well within kicking distance directly out in front, Katie.
Yeah, most definitely sneaky. That's what they call her, and that's why she's got the name. If she can slot this one, it's going to be a great start for the Tars, exactly the kind of momentum they want starting off the quarter.
Just to be a cheap goal if she gets it. They left her unattended, Sue Nolder, directly out in front. Comes in and from straight out in front, bangs away. It looks okay. It looks better than okay. Tars get the first one off the boot of Sue Nolder.
Yeah, there she goes. And that's what she's done. And if they can start and keep continuing this, they're going to have a very close game on their hands. Southern Districts need to answer back quite quickly with that one.
Need to do some checking back there. Here's the kick. You can see it on replay. Taylor Thorne was looking. There was one on two. Ball was kicked to ground, and this hurried kick here was just, it was a kick and hope, wasn't it?
Yeah,
although
Maddie
they
Golds
had loose players down there, didn't they,
Tars? They did, yeah. They had a few options.
Well, that was Madeline Galt that kicked that ball into Nolder, and she was one of the finds last year in the grand final. Yeah. It's punched away quickly there by Ebony Miller. Loose kick, heading back towards the Tars goal. Running through, can't quite pick it up. Looks like Letitia Jeffrey has got a hold of it. Hurried handball away, call is play on. She goes for a second effort. Back over the top, and the play will be settled down, and it'll be Ebony Miller who will restart it for Districts.
Plays for the Red Tails in Alice Springs, comes up for this game every week. Daughter of the great Chippy Miller, ball towards the boundary line. High tackle over the top. Umpire said it's all okay. It's along the boundary line. They won't bring that one out, and the ump's going to come in and ball it up. Umpire there, number 11, is Andre Price Quinter. He's just 17 years of age, and he's played, he's umpired over nearly 200 games. This is 198 for him.
Well, he's actually, all three of those umpires there are under the age of 18 today. All Premier League umpires as well, Charlie. So they've umpired men's Premier League, and Paddy did a men's Premier League semi-final a couple of weeks ago. Back in the middle, throwing over, Rhiannon Bush. In fact, that was college. Oh, taken high there. Free kicks being paid in the middle. Tars with all the ascendancy early. They bring it out wide. Run off the halfback. They'll set that up there for Alicia. Tisha Jeffrey can't quite get it. Picked up. Here they go again. Moving forward, Alicia Stanley. Long forward. That's Nolder. Already the goal scorer so far in this game. Nolder looks further upfield. She's got the leading Lauren O'Shea who overruns it. Can't quite get it. Pushed out. Now it's loose. Here they go again. Quick hands. Out it comes to Nolder. Nolder, right foot. Lines it up to full forward. Backing in there was Kerenua. Crumbing was O'Shea. Couldn't quite get it. Loose. Pushed in the back. Let go by the umpire. Play on's the call. Letting it go today. Important grand final. Ball's going to be held up there, you would think, and the ball will be balled up about 35 metres out.
Yeah, I think they're just smothering everything, those Tars girls, getting in, not letting anything get away once Districts have picked it up.
Tap down by Miller, gathered in this time by DeMello. Pack gets over the top, a bit scrambly early on. Lots of pressure being applied here. I spoke to the two coaches earlier on, and Tom and Elliot said, intensity, tough brand of footy, you'll win it for us. Colleen Gwynn said, we're going to do what we always do, play a basic game of footy and play it straight. Running hard at the footy, here's Stasevich, got the handball away. Intercept was pretty good. Handball back under pressure. That's Reed for Southern Districts. Kick to the middle, bounced away from Stanley. Didn't run hard at the footy. Good steal there by Sharona Bishop, rather. Kicked forward, parked underneath it. Purantata Mary drops the ball, leaves it behind. We'll get a second chance. No, she won't. They're under real pressure here, Southern Districts. Tars players everywhere. Bounces at the 50, rolls towards the boundary line, and then rolls over the boundary line and out of play. So 4.5 minutes gone. A goal to nothing, Waratahs in front.
Yeah, that intensity, you can see it just from both sides. Both teams are wanting it just as much as each other. They're both hungry. It's great to see.
College can't quite get a hand on it. Loose over the back there. Lisa Roberts can't pick it up either. Coming through was Bishop. Districts, though, they're all away. Alicia Healy picks it up, then gives it off to her teammate, Alicia Stanley. Her kick was smothered, and the ball will go out of bounds. I've got to say, Charlie, I think Southern Districts have been one of the biggest improvers in the Women's Premier League comp. Certainly a couple of years ago, they were being well beaten, and Tarman has stuck with it.
They finished seventh, I think, last year.
Yeah.
He said they're unlucky not to finish fifth, but the percentage kept them in seventh position. Here's the kick gathered in by Collegey. She goes with a kick to a vacant half-forward line, bounces at the 50. Tars get there first. No, they don't. Was left behind. Plenty of numbers at the fall of the ball. Here's Stasevich. Kick inside 50. Turned it over. Good mark. Taken in defence there. That's Miller. Ebony Miller kicks it out wide. Bouncing ball. She kicked it poorly because she gave them a chance out there. Here's Lisa Roberts. She'll get to it and kick it off the ground. She's done really well. Got it down towards the half forward line. Went and foxed it down herself. Caught, got the kick away in a hurry. It was half smothered. Ball bounces freely. Work back there in defence. Southern District can't quite get clear. Tars working hard, but District standing up in defence here. They've only let Tars kick one goal despite the fact that all the play has been on the left-hand side, isn't it?
Yeah, having Ebony Miller down there to cut those off as well. She's just going to work so hard on that back line. Indy Sleeth is the same.
Well, I'm watching there, and Sharona Bishop looks like she's set herself up a kick behind as Roberts off the hands, then kicks it wide. It's going to bounce away, though. Districts will settle it down and kick it towards the scoreboard. Centre wing. Bishop, that's the person I was talking about a minute ago. Letitia Jeffrey gets a handball hurried away. Becky Pryor's in there. There's Jeffrey again. Sorry, my mistake. Putting plenty of pressure on Becky Pryor. Loose. Bishop smothers off the boot. Kick away. There we have it. Districts will settle this right down.
Tars had five players around the fall of that ball, and all those extra Southern District players were back there, and they cut it off. They did well. Here's Holtz with the kick along the boundary line. She's searching for a teammate. Lost it, though. Stolen by Lisa Robert. She goes away, gets a bounce, can get a couple in if she wants. Goes off the right boot. Kick forward. Was cut off in defence again. They're pretty good back there. This is Rachel McHugh. She's across the half-back line on that far side of the ground. Chips it up high. Sets it high. Tars in front position. Got knocked out of it. Umpire said it was all okay. Handball was intended for Sleeth. Didn't get to her. Tars win the kick. Get it inside 50. Ball bounces loose. But good run out of defence now. Here she comes charging forward. Taylor Thorne. She's a great footballer. Kicks it down over the wing. They haven't been inside 50 yet, Southern District. They'll be worrying about that, about this point in the match. Gathered in here by Pryor. Kick to the centre of the ground. Galt got to it. Kicks it high inside 50. Pack forms underneath it. Ball goes to ground. Runners come. Oh, they might have grabbed it without the footy. Tars got away with it. Kick off the left boot. And going forward, taking a mark. If you get in front position down in the forward line, you're probably going to take the mark. If it drops a little short, and that's exactly what happened there for DeMello.
Yeah, it's the break they needed right here. Lisa Roberts, anytime that ball goes anywhere near the back line, she's just going to come through and take care of it. That's her specialty for sure.
So directly out in front, Jade DeMello. Well, almost directly out in front. It might as well have been. She splits the middle, straight through the middle, and Tars have got two. At the eight-minute mark, Tars lead two goals straight. Southern District's yet to score. Katie Strader.
They're going to have to work on this one. First ball up, straight into it. I'm sure they're feeling quite nervous. But this playback right here, we can see Maddie Goltz, and she kicks it straight down. And even though there's that pressure, they just haven't stopped. They're still working so hard at it.
Just read this beautifully. She just read it beautifully off the boot. Just left her opponent right on time.
Good crowd here. Real good crowd here today. Packed. I couldn't get a car park. Ash, you were here early.
Charlie, you must have arrived very, very late.
Katie had a car park.
Just.
Miller gets the tap. She's been terrific already, Miller. Comes out. They threw the ball out there. Collegey, umpire said it's okay. Tars with a scramble kick forward. Worked pretty well. Landed in the hands there of Pippa Cox. And back into the hands here of Lisa Roberts. Great leader she is. Hard, desperate work back there. Musa, who's been good in defence for them. Ball pushed towards the boundary line. Chase out there. DeMello kicks it up a little further and out of play and out of play on the full.
Out of bounds on the full.
So free kick down there to Musa. Working in defence. Man, there looked a bit like the CEO of AFLNT. Here's Musa's kick from that far side of the ground. And what's she done? She returned the favour. I think she has. I think she's kicked it out of bounds herself.
Those nerves.
So free kick here. Sharona Bishop. Well, it's not a free kick to Sharona Bishop, but Bishop actually got played for Tracy Village in a couple of years ago.
She did, yes. I think she's had the last two seasons, including this one at Tars. And it's
been a handy acquisition for Waratahs.
Most definitely.
Pippa Cox sends it forward. Picks out a teammate there with a very weighted pass, Amy Chittick. And that's her first touch so far. She's usually very useful across half forward. That's a great mark there taken by Indy Sleeth. What you want in a defender. Kicks across the face of goal. That'll be a coach killer. As comes loose, competition. Pryor dives on it. She better get rid of it or she's going to get pinged. Play on is the call. In fact, the umpire says, give it to me and I'll ball it up. 55 metres out from goal. Good field position for Tars. College taps it away. Alicia Stanley trying to knock it forward, and she does. Lisa Roberts sockers it off the ground for Tars. Comes out to DeMello. Now on to Galt. Right foot sets it up to the goals. Off hands of Lauren O'Shea. Cleaned up again. There comes Taylor Thorne for Districts, and she sends it out of the defence onto centre wing.
Stolen there by Tars. Go forward off the boot of Bishop. Was okay. Bouncing ball. Just dropped a little bit short. Look at them run hard at the ball. Gee, Tars are playing great footy here at the moment. I'll tell you what, Districts are just taking everything that's been thrown at them.
They are. Alicia Stanley in there. She's been in the contest every couple of 10 seconds in.
So Southern Districts win the tap down, can't get it away. Crawford with the footy, got caught, went to ground with it. She holds it in there, hands all over it. Umpire says, give it to me. Neil will ball it up. Edge of the square here. We've ticked past 11 minutes of the grand final. Tars playing Southern Districts here at the TIO Stadium in Darwin. Good tap down, Southern Districts. Kick out wide, rolling into a vacant wing. Southern Districts will get there first. Have left it behind. Chance there for Hoogerville Hill. She didn't get the hands on the footy, though. Kicks it down towards the forward line. Crawford in front. Couldn't pick it up for Southern Districts. They emerge with the footy, though. The Crocodiles kick it out wide. The tackle was pretty good. Ball is heading towards the boundary line. Just stays in the field of play. Still in the field of play. It is desperate. The tackling is fantastic. They're not going to bring it out of there. Wow, that's some tough footy being played out there. I'll tell you something, Katie Streeter, you would not want to be out there.
Oh, that's pretty relentless. You'd be pretty exhausted, I can tell, just from looking.
Kelsey Patterson with a big tackle there. Back in with College, punched away from Miller, then cleaned up by Alicia Stanley. Chittick can't pick it up, Mitt front on, let go. Sleeth can't get it away. Everyone's on it, hands and knees. Looks like O'Shea's come away from goal. She has to try and get some possessions, get the hand on the ball. Goal, here they come. Districts, back to center. Field, Sharona High, I thought. Play on is the call. Now Districts for the first time inside their 50 in this quarter. It's going to be a bouncing ball. Loose, picked up beautifully there by Deegan. She has a bouncing kick. And it's through for their first score of the day. 13 minutes gone here in this first term. Two straight goal, Waratahs 12, 1 point Districts.
No, they really need to turn this one over, give them that momentum to go into that second quarter. They can turn it over, build that wall, the Districts girls, and then snap a quick goal, they'll be setting themselves up quite nicely.
From a positive scoring point of view, Charlie, Districts are at 100% first time inside their 50.
Sharona Bishop kicks to herself, runs to the back pocket and thumps it out to 50. That is a great kick. She set it up for a teammate. Couldn't take the mark, though. Ball towards the boundary line. Went back and picked it up under pressure, though. Pippa Cox came back in field. She runs in support. Cox didn't give it to her. Good work, Molly Cooper. Got the kick up towards the half forward line. It's a real feature of Tars' play at the moment. They're hitting targets just about all the time, aren't they? Yep. Their kicking skill is really, really good. Here's Collegey under pressure. Lost it, though. Handball towards the middle. Collegey will probably ruck just about all day today. She has the audacity to take one bounce, gets onto the left boot, spears it in. That's a magnificent bit of play. Puts it in the hands of Nolder. Nolder inside 50, finds another teammate. There it is, kicking to players, and a good mark taken down there by Chittick. Yeah. Wow, what good play Tars.
Alicia Healy, well done.
Yeah. So first season for Tars, is it this year? Might be a second, actually. She's just come over from netball, and geez, she's... You play against her and she's just rough as, tough as.
She backed herself just then.
So Chittick, now a bit of an angle, all but directly out in front, kicks that goal and misses it out to the right. Comes up with a minor score. Colleen Gwynn was telling me earlier on, very impressed with Amy Chittick this year. She'll set her up in the forward line. She's got fitter, she's running more, and her skill level has improved. So look for a big game for her. So pressure here, Thorne to bring the ball back into play here for Southern Districts.
She decides to go long and wide outside that 50 metre, get it as far away from goals as we can. Lisa Roberts leads the race to the ball, decides not to pick it up. Instead, she's trying to tap it to her teammate at College, but she gets dragged off it. Now it's picked up and kicked forward. College here, loose comes in. And there is Purantata Mary. Oh, taken high. And we'll get a free kick for her troubles. And she'll have a shot. She'll go back and take the kick. Be right on the edge of her distance, though. She'll probably end up kicking from about 40. And she looks to pass off, and she's got the lead there as O'Shea. Two or three against one, not clear. Now it's kicked out of that 50.
Kick out wide, rolling ball out there, overrunning the footy out there was Miller, went back looking for it. Caught tackle was very good, almost dispossessed the player. Spills to Pippa Cox, she's out on that far side of the ground, got it across to Stasevich, couldn't get the kick away. Southern District's doing pretty well here, they've won it again from their half-back line. Kick to the middle, it's measured nice, that's a good kick. The mark was dropped though, and they overran the footy, and Tars were back there in numbers. Little chip kick to the middle of the ground, mark taken there by Bree Martin. Looks up, not much on offer. She'll want a lead in the middle. She finds a loose player standing all alone. No defenders back there. And Alicia Healy takes the mark. Gets onto that left boot inside 50. Two defenders there. Knock it away cleverly from Chittick. Ball down towards the defensive 50 for Southern District. They dive over the top of it. Collegey down there with it. Handball comes out in the direction of Stasevich. Ball kicked out towards the wing. Front position out there. Southern District get a push in the back. And they win a free kick and be able to relieve some pressure. And it is intense.
Bella Clark sending it into the centre of the ground. In there is Galt. Steps one, then got taken high. Free kick will come. She gets dumped for her troubles.
And it's just that composure the Tars are showing again. They're stopping, they're looking, they're using the ground so well. Players are setting up, they're giving themselves plenty of space.
Out wide, finds Roberts. Roberts goes over the top, but it's going to be cut off there. Ball's wrapped up, loose. Umpire just lets it go. Get that ball out, get it moving. Chittick diving on it. Hurried handball out just to keep it moving towards goal. Sock it off the ground and sock it again at the goal. But a free kick's been found.
Went for a goal.
went for a goal. The goal umpire didn't look very interested then, Charlie. Just watched it roll over the line, did Natalie Butt. Paddy Rawshorn there brings it back and they'll restart play.
So on that far side of the ground again, 17 and a half minutes gone. It's the grand final if you've just joined us. It's Waratahs and Southern District. 13 plays, won a couple of goals the margin. It's been all Tars up in that forward line, but the defence has been terrific from Southern District. They'll take heart out of that. High up and under kick mark taken, Maddie Galt. She points long. That's where she's going to go, and she does. It's a good-looking kick to inside 50. Nearly got it over the top. Good mark taken back there. Engelhardt in defence for the tricolours. Goes short with the kick. Bree Martin a chance. Overran the footy. Left it here for Southern District to get clear. Siren goes. Good quarter of footy. Belonged to Waratahs in the main, though. They go into the break here. 2-1-13. Southern District 1 point. Let's get a comment from Katie Stretter.
Yeah, I think the Tars are just coming in. They've come out so strong. They've had clean skills. They've been composed. They're really thinking about how they want the ball to move down the ground. Southern Districts look a little rattled, maybe. They just need to settle their nerves. Hopefully they can regain that composure in the huddle and come.
She's flying down to Alice today.
Don't forget to put away the garden furniture.
Yep, got it.
And just remember the TIO weather alerts. Garden furniture!
Love you too.
She's off, but he's still got TIO. They cover you for territory weather. Cyclone, storm surge, flood, hail, and they're local, so they can respond fast.
TIO? Storm staying, kids.
Yeah!
Another life saved with the Chemist Warehouse app. Take control of your health and wellness. Download now.
Mother Nature can be frighteningly predictable in the Territory this time of year. Heavy rains and damaging winds can cause significant problems and disruption, particularly if you're unprepared, while downed power lines and flash flooding can be lethal. To ensure you're ready, visit powerwater.com.au/safety or text safety to 0428 323 991 for more information. Because staying safe and ready around Mother Nature should be second nature.
CFS Schoolwear is the perfect choice for quality custom-made school uniforms. Ideal clothing for all school-related activities, whether it's 50 or 500 students, we have what you need. Contact the Cricket and Football Shop NT for your free CFS Schoolwear quote today.
Let's see. Roma? Verona?
Perhaps Barcelona.
Make your dream holiday a reality. Book your next getaway at Flight Centre with interest-free holidays and flexible repayment options.
Best in the air.
And everywhere. Flight Centre.
Intersport, new concept store now opening Casuarina Square. Come in and check out a world-class shopping experience.
Dedicated sports zones.
Now stocking only the biggest brands in tennis, cricket, fitness from treadmills to benches, boxing, swimming, darts, pool and table tennis. For awesome service and advice,
come and see us.
Still locally owned and operated, the all-new Intersport concept store.
Now open at Casuarina Square.
Boys, we've got a real big problem. It belongs to you, it belongs to me, it belongs to everybody. I'm talking about family violence. It's time we said no more to family violence, isn't it?
Yeah.
Think about it.
We've all got to say no more to family violence.
No more!
Family violence is a community problem and it needs a community response from all of us, and sport is a big part of that. But we can all do our bit by being more respectful to each other. Please make this year the year we say no more to family violence.
All right, just a reminder, the halftime of this game will be the Hot 100 halftime sprint. So if you are one of the sprinters that are representing your club, if you can please make your way just down to the front of the grandstand. We would like to start marking the ball off. So that is everyone, all the sprinters that are racing and your halftime sprint representing your club, please make your way down to the front of the grandstand.
Second quarter about to get underway here. They've broken. You can see the score there. 12 points the difference. Katie Stretter, what are we going to see in this quarter?
Yeah, hopefully if districts can break away with that centre and get it down their end and try and keep it back within their scoring end, it's going to take the pressure off a lot. They worked really hard in that last quarter to keep it defensively off their goal kickers for TARS, so hopefully that's going to be their goals.
Umpire holds it aloft. We're underway with Ash Menakaris.
Back in the middle, knocked away. Thorne comes running through and then sends it forward. Here they go, districts trying to rebound quickly and get some presence back on that scoreboard. Loose on the ground. In there was Stanley, couldn't get it, kicked off the ground. Play on is the call, and then there's a solid mark taken in defence there. And she's taken off and been caught holding the ball.
This could be it.
This could be the opportunity that districts are looking for. And it's in the hands of Amelia Bartlett. Good tackle. Well, looked like Rapsom Staropoli there took off, Charlie.
Yeah, she thought she had a bit more time than she did.
Bartlett comes in, but the kick just goes off to the right. They've doubled their score to 2 points.
Got to kick those, don't you, when you get the opportunity,
so.
Grand final day.
I think grand finals, you don't want to rue them later.
For the ball to be brought back out from defence by TARS. That's Rapsom Staropoli, kicks it outside 50. They get players there. Hard running there by Lisa Roberts. She is some player, and she on the left boot kicks it around the body. It's a good-looking kick. Parked underneath it, not able to take the mark, was Bella Clark. Comes off hands and out of play. District's players looking on there.
Tarman Elliott, the coach there on the left, arms folded.
The Rucks put their hand up there. It's going to be Sleeth. Boundary umpire throw didn't do them any favours, though. Went out wide. Tars with the handball. Along the boundary line they go. Went searching back in. Stolen that time by Musa. Musa kicks up towards the 50-metre line. In front, Tars there in defence, trying to kick it off the ground. Lisa Roberts, terrific play by her again. But Southern Districts with the kick inside 50. They have a player in good position. They got over the back, though, and dropping back there, taking a strong mark, was Sharona Bishop.
Yeah, she reads it so well, Sharona.
And again, onto that trusty right boot, hugging the boundary line. Went over the back, and a good mark taken there for Southern Districts by Engelhart. They got to her. She got the handball away. They gave it to Bush. Bush's kick inside 50. Front position. Tars. That's what Tars are just playing in front, aren't they? They're awake to that. Those kicks will drop a little short, and they've figured it out.
Better pressure here from Districts. Trying to keep it inside that 50 is Thorne. Danger. Right foot. Sends it forward. Teammate was there. Couldn't quite get a hold of it. That looked like Corpus. Couldn't quite get clean possession. Second effort though, here they come again. Oh, dragged off the ball with a great tackle was Deegan, and a hurried kick away. Trying to relieve the pressure there was Trish Muller. The ball's hugging that boundary line. Muller came and put pressure on the district's players. The ball's gone out of bounds, will be thrown in. Colleen Gwynn there on the left to screen. Two coaches.
Red and white army looks on, don't they?
See if red and white.
Is the hit from the back. Sleeth knocked it towards the boundary line. Collegey gets it up towards the wing and just short of. Gee, he's been, Musa's been terrific back there in defence. He's got plenty of it. She's a desperate player. We see that from her. They emerge with the footy, though. Sleeth with the kick. Dropped it in a little short. Again in front position. Tars win it. Healy went with the left boot. Just couldn't quite get the ball away. Gathered in this time by Sleeth. Sleeth's kick inside 50. Bouncing ball out in front of Bishop. And Bishop on the charge. She's got two to beat if she gets to it. She won't get there in time. It's rushed out of play. Deegan in front position there for Southern District. Sees it out of play. There's some Southern District supporters looking on.
Yeah, Maria Musa, she's just a really hard worker around the ball. Again, another one of those players reads it very well.
I've got to tell you, Charlie, this battle between Collegey and Sleeth is unfolding and very important. One out there by Sleeth, and it went to Bella Clark. She sent it up to Letitia Jeffrey. Oh, beautifully picked up there. Couldn't quite get away with it. And another great tackle. The ball's loose. Alicia Stanley cleans up for Waratah, sends it out. But it's all districts there at the moment. Plenty of time do they have. Hurried handball, although in the end, good pressure by Tars as they closed in. It's the reliable Lisa Roberts who eases the pressure. And the ball off the bottom of the boot goes out of bounds. It was Rochelle McHugh from districts.
She did the right thing, didn't she?
Yeah,
McHugh.
Yeah, she's, and I think it's just the fact that the Tars girls are working so well in numbers as well. They're just making sure they're making that job very hard.
Is the throw that goes right back over the top of Sleeth. She went back looking for the ruck player. Didn't get it though. Little kick forward here. Down towards the edge of the square. Players get over the top of it. Trying to knock it out there was Miller. Gets into the hand of this very busy player today, Musa. Her performance is as good as what they're getting from Lisa Roberts, I reckon. Pack gets over the top of it. Not able to get it out. Now it comes through. Musa gets there and kicks it off the ground. She's a one person... back six.
She's covering a lot of ground.
Maria Musa.
Most definitely. We played her a couple of weeks ago and she's, relentless.
Collegey with the tap out there, but it was gone to the district's player. Trying to pick it up, though, is O'Hare. Now Chittick looking for a teammate. Loose hands under pressure in the middle and it's going to be kicked forward to a contest. Here comes, coming through there for districts, is Hooganveen Hill. Picked up though by Bishop. And then it's Collegey, hurried hands. And there again is O'Hare. She'll go back and look further forward. On the lead is Nolder and hits her on the chest. Great pass.
Again.
And Sue Nolder from 40 out.
Yeah. Just the star from Sue Nolder. Again, plays that front role really well, reads the play. Takes those dives. It's not uncommon.
And the lead in. Taylor Thorne was there. So McHugh can't get a hold of it. Socket off the ground. Districts will want it out of there. Quick smart. And it's going to go out of bounds. How good was the pass from O'Hare then, Charlie?
Yeah, terrific.
Into Sue Nolder, wasn't it?
Yeah, just so much accuracy.
So deep down in the forward line here for the Tars. They lead by 11 points. They got a chance here. They've got the breeze in this quarter. It swung around because it's a bit of a storm building in the distance. Here's a kick out of the pack. Collegey didn't quite get it away. District's now under pressure. Handball gets out. Kick got out wide. She's under enormous pressure back there, O'Hare. Got the kick away. Good defensive punch at the boundary line from Thorne, or from the goal line, rather, and knocks it through for a minor score. Desperate work, Taylor Thorne back there. Good player, Taylor Thorne.
Yeah, she is. She's one of those girls that you could describe her as a bit of a weapon. She just comes through and, takes over, takes whether she's in the back line, forward line, gets the job done.
Daughter of the great Tommy Thorne. We used to see him play up here years ago for the Buffaloes. Kicks it out wide. Front position, Tars. Handball around the corner by Collegey. Trying to run desperately out of defence, Jeffrey. They did get the kick away, though, but in the way down there is Stanley for Tars. She didn't get to the footy, though. She gave Southern Districts a chance. They do emerge with the football through Corpus. Under pressure now, it gets into the hands of Reed. Reed can't get Clitchy. The heads went down. Looked like a head clash was imminent. It wasn't. Little knock off the ground. Tars with the red circle around the outside of the pack. That's working pretty well for them as well. Bounces inside 50. Gathered by Nolder. Squares it up and kicks down towards the pocket. Knocked away and out of play. So under pressure again. Southern Districts have been under pressure for just about all of this match. Those back six defenders are working so hard.
Donna Reed especially, she's been covering all this ground. She was just over here in the pocket before, then back up into the middle.
Yep, Crawford and Thorne then, the last line of defence. Leith first hands on it, starting to get slightly on top of Collegey for Tars. The ball's going to be locked up and it'll be balled up. It's in good field position for the red and whites. Just what I'm saying, Sleeth doing a mountain of work against Collegey and just starting to get on top for my money. She wins that knockout again. Socket off the ground. Letitia Jeffries there can't quite pick it up. Running into trouble though from Waratahs was Muller. Ball's loose on the ground. Now it's Stewart's just popped out. Socket from midair. It's Purantata Mary looking for teammates. Nolder copped a little bit of a hand in the back and she'll get a free kick for it. That was Thorne. Well, Thorne just put that hand out there right into Nolder's back. Umpire was in a great spot.
Yeah, and that's, they're not going to miss those ones in a game like this today. So I think Sue Nolder, she's got what it takes from here.
And the breeze is blowing to the right hand of the of your screen, and she goes in short looking for Martin. Punched off it though. Coming through was Thorne, keen to make up from the last mistake. Then picks out a teammate. Very good foot pass, well weighted. Finds Hoogenveen Hill.
Inspirational play, wasn't it? Hoogenveen Hill got it on the half back line. Kicks it up towards the wing. Plenty of players there. Tars, the chance to take a mark. Weren't able to do it though through Pryor. Little kick here for Southern Districts back into the corridor. Or almost to the corridor. Run down from behind. Umpire says it's a free kick. Chance to get clear with it and get the handball out. She didn't, and she's been penalised. Holt. And the free kick goes to Tars. They're across their half back line. Kick up over the wing. It's a big kick. It's a real big kick. Nest of three Crocodiles there. There was a high tackle over the top. The umpire didn't quite see it. Ball towards the boundary line. Picked up almost there by Hoogenveen Hill. Desperate work back there in defence. Lisa Roberts did really well. Got a teammate clear with it. Kick towards the edge of the square. Dropping back with the ball in front of her was Bush. Didn't take the mark though. Had to run with the flight of the ball. Little handball came out by Sleeth. Lost it though. Caught from behind. Tars player driven into the ground. Whistle goes. Umpire's going to play a free kick. And the free kick is going to go, I reckon, to Collegey.
Yeah.
Joe Collegey.
Dragged down by Sleeth. Just off the ball.
Great battle between the two.
It is a tremendous. This could be the battle of the day. As Collegey kicks up the line looking for Chittick. She doesn't quite get front position. Quick handball out. Now's Chittick's chance. But free kick's been found. It'll be too high. And it will go to, who is that, Charlie? That's Juliana Kerenua. We'll go back and have a kick. She's a bit slow getting up. She's got the lead. Oh, great take.
Sue Nolder.
Well done. Great lead, great pass. Just put it out in front, sat it up. In front of Moosa, Charlie.
Well, it's as good as Moosa is. It's a little height mismatch, isn't it, really?
Yes. And I don't think anyone would have got that. That's how good the pass was, and the lead was up to it as well. She looks to offload. Martin sets herself up in the middle corridor, though. Takes two bites at it. Punched away. Play on is the call. Still in that middle corridor. O'Hare tackled without it. Play on is the call. Ball still loose. No one can quite get clean possession until it's picked up by Collegey. Puts it straight on the boot. Bouncing to Mellows there. So too is Chittick, although coming through and trying to clean it out is Miller, and Miller does that, gets it to the 50. Jeffrey can't quite get clean possession. There was Healy, hurried handball.
A little kick down towards the pocket. Miller again working desperately in defence. They'll get out of trouble here, Southern District. I'll tell you what's happened. Out on that far side of the ground, you might have heard the thunder in the background. We might get a storm. If you get two or three goals in front here, it's going to be really hard to try and peg that back again. Tars with the ball out on the wing. Kick it down towards the edge of the square. Gets over the top. Runners come from everywhere, including Stanley. Stanley couldn't get it. Handball was intended there for Pemba. Kick to the edge of the square. Here's Taylor Thorne working it out in front of her. Did really well. Got a couple of touches. Couldn't get clear with it. Puruntata Mary didn't get to the footy. Spillage came out into the hands of Clark. Big tackle over the top. Ball held up. Umpire's going to have a look and then ball it up. Gee, the pressure is on. Mm-hmm. It is a tough game, isn't it?
It is. It most definitely is. And I think that districts just need to get that accuracy with their kicks. Have a good look.
12 and a half minutes gone here in this second quarter. Punch forward. Jeffrey trying to lead the race to the ball. It's picked up though by a teammate, Pemba. Pemba's kick is cut off with Galt. Galt's got Brianna Martin at centre half forward all on alone, but the kick goes offside and there's Sleeth. Done a mountain of work in this quarter as Sleeth looks for a target and can't really find one. Pryor couldn't take it. Thorne was there, put pressure on her. Ball's still loose, knocked out. Picking it up is Healy. Left foot, looking for a target. She finds DeMello.
Gee, she's been playing well.
And DeMello will turn and go into that 50.
So DeMello's kick is pretty good too. Gee, that's a good kick to Chittick. She got behind the line, took the mark, looks up, sees a player running loose, down in the forward line. Looks like there'll be a goal. Clever tap over the top. Tackle was really good. Defence terrific. Out comes Musa. She did really well. Kicked it outside the 50-metre line. Running hard at the footy down there. Maddie Gold gets to it, gets on the bike, goes back, lines up, kicks for goal out to the left and misses and comes up with a minor score.
Maddie Galt, what a work rate.
What about Brianna Martin then? She set that up at centre half forward and then managed to double back and be
the
an option.
Work rate.
We're ticked past 14 minutes. A little short kick into the back pocket. They have defended relentlessly, Southern District, from the start of the game. And they're really under pressure here. And the breeze favouring Waratahs at the moment. Kick outside 50. Underneath the footy, not able to take the mark, was Opperman. Now back to move. What a game she's having. Onto the right boot she goes. That's a great kick to the edge of the square. She had two players to one out there. And the one wins for Tars. Looks up. Kicks inside 50. Turned it straight over into the hands of Sleeth again.
And Sleeth finds a teammate. That's Tess Hannah. Little short pass. Trying to set it up for Patterson. Bouncing ball. But she's got a mountain of time. In front of that scoreboard. 2-3-15. Plays 2 points. Districts, is it Lakeisha Jeffrey, turns back inside.
Yep.
Bouncing though, it's picked up by Bishop, dodges one, beats one, puts it on the boot. It's gone back out towards the scoreboard and there's Lisa Roberts. She just turns and sends it back. DeMello has the sit, reads it beautifully, tries to drag it back in, still bouncing ball, sockers it on to keep it in front of her. It's going to get to Miller though, then DeMello is following it up, just keeping that ball moving forward, and a free kick's been found. We'll go to Miller. Oh, so there's lightning in the background there.
Yes, and we know the lightning rule here. If it gets dangerous, they'll bring them off. And the little kick to outside 50, and there's the siren. But they'll go into the break here in comfortably in front. Tars have withstood everything, but so have Sutton Districts. It's set up for a beauty. 2-3 leads Districts 2. 13 points to margin.
So kids, everyone needs to stay off the field for halftime. We are conducting the Hot 100 halftime sprint. We need all the room. And we need you in the grounds cheering for your club. We're going to invite the girls out very shortly to represent the club. Now, we're going to find the fastest woman in the NTFL. No. I think we're still waiting on a couple of contestants, a couple of people. St. Mary's Rosalind Stark. St. Mary's Rosalind Stark. We can hurry and come down. And Jenna Singh from Waratahs. When we see you guys, we don't want you to miss out. $700 for the fastest lady. All right, it does still remain pretty close game. Waratahs going in for their halftime break with a slight lead, 2-3-15 to Districts 2-4. Thank you. the halftime 100 metre sprint, the fastest woman in the NTFL will be crowned here today. And next week, as part of the Men's Premier League game, we will have the fastest man. So that's next week in the Men's Grand Final. We do have a competitor from each club representing. There are a few clubs missing, you may notice. But the winner today will take home $700. And second place, $350, with third place taking $200. I feel like they're going to have to try and outrun this rain to make it a very interesting race. So we're just making sure we've got the full 100 metres set up. The girls are getting warmed up as we speak. And I think we'll make our way down the finish line so we'll be there for the winning girl.
Big job. Just unplug all this shit from in here.
Well, we're back with it. We had a storm that came in like you've never seen. It was almost like a little tornado. It blew the flags off the flagpoles. And the players went out, much to their credit, they've gone out and continued to play. So we're about 3 minutes in this third quarter, and Tars there adding a point to their... Southern Districts rather adding a point to their score. The rain, would you have known, Katie Shredder, which team plays better in the weather?
You couldn't see past the window up to start with, Charlie, so I'd say that we haven't had enough wet games this season to actually be able to tell, if any.
Well, here's the little kick out. Look at that water out there. This is extraordinary. That, actually, they can call the game off, though, can't they, if lightning is it gets too close? And we've seen some flashes of it.
Yeah, we have seen a flash of lightning, but I don't think they will call this off now. Now it's just rain, a little bit of thunder, but that's about it.
Bush doing the good ruck work there. Pat gets over the top of the footy. The umpire's going to come in. We'll see a lot of stop-start here. So down in that forward line for Southern Districts. Hard to kick some goals here. Running in there, Reed didn't get it. Left it behind. High up and under kick there came from Bouverveen Hill. Little snap kick out of the pack. Little snap out of the pack. Goes along the boundary line. Sharona Bishop done well. Got the kick out toward 50. Plenty of Southern District players there. They look better in the wet than the Tars do.
They do, don't they?
Yeah, most definitely going to come down to determination, isn't it?
Smothering effort there, sees it out of play. 2-3 plays three, still 12 points the difference.
Well, I've got to say to you, Charlie, they've actually been pushing the ball forward. As we hear that crack of thunder in the background. In there is Miller, diving on it, can't get it out for Districts. Ball still loose on the ground. Dragged in is Collegey. So what do you think, Katie, in terms of the way Districts has responded to the wet weather?
Oh, it looks like they've got a whole new lease on life. I mean, it's going to stop that the ball hitting targets with the Tars, which is what has really given them the advantage.
No, in fact, the whistle's just sounded there, and they've said to abandon play for the time being, I think, and they'll leave the field because of the lightning and the rain, and the siren that you hear is to let everyone know that they have to leave the field. And what you'll see now is there'll be an interruption to the game, and it can't restart. It has to restart within 30 minutes. Otherwise, we'll end up with the result. So player safety here and umpire safety taken into account. So it's the lightning, and clearly it was deemed a bit close.
And the rule says that the team that is in front, if this game is abandoned after half-time, gets awarded the match.
Yes, and this is the thing, Charlie, is that a game has to have completed at least a half of football for there to be a result. And now we're into that third quarter, a result can come.
And Districts doing what Districts should do, so absolute reluctance to leave the field.
Yes. How disappointing. If that has to be the case, just anything can happen in a half of footy, especially when it's this low scoring and the pressure has been so consistent. It could be a real turnaround if they did have a good chance to have complete the whole full half. So it'll be interesting to see what happens.
So Districts leave the field now. Tars already went down the tunnel. And we'll have to wait and see. So what's the time? 5:30.
ladies and gentlemen, once again, just letting you know the game has been called by the umpires due to lightning. That does mean that all kids need to stay on both fields as well. So if kids can please make their way back into the grandstand. It is due to lightning and it's for the safety of the players and the patrons. So please just remain on the field and we will come back to you shortly with an update on today's game. gentlemen, please get warmed up again. We have a very big game to get into. Waratahs and Southern District in the Women Premier League Grand Final is about to begin again. Just to confirm, it will take off at the time that is on the screen. They are 6 minutes into the quarter. So this is still another exciting, almost 10 minutes of footy to go.
So it looks like we've got a resumption of play here. They've come off at the six-minute mark of the third term. We're going to pick it up from there. Tars 2 goals, 3 lead, and Southern District 3 points. Here's Ash Manakaris.
Restart back there straight away. It's in good field position for Southern Districts. They proved themselves in the first 6 minutes to put the pressure on Tars. They've responded better to the wet weather conditions. The ball's going to be locked up. It's going to be let go, though, by the umpire. Let it come out. DeMello tries to soccer it off instead of trying to pick it up. Now she picks it up, puts it on the boot, gets outside the 50 there. Sleeth. Sleeth, right foot, straight in, long and deep. Off hands, bouncing. Roberts can't quite get a hold of it. Neither can Healy. Oh, coming through there quickly was Taylor Thorne. Couldn't get clean hands. Not surprising in these conditions, as Healy will run away from it and Tars hopefully will get out of trouble.
Healy on the left boot kicks it out to defensive 50. Oh, that's great, a terrific mark. Reaching over the back. What did you make of that?
Yeah, I think she read it well. She positioned herself. Now there's a chance for Crocs to try and get some more points on the board.
So Bella Clark's kick inside 50. Just barely went the distance. Stolen there by Bartlam. Tried to get it over the top to give it off to Deegan. Ball on the ground. No one able to get a clear possession. Tars looking for it, working hard in front position. Healy. He's had a good game today, Healy. Got it out wide. Linked it up there with the Pryor. And now a chance here for Stasevich. Ball down towards the 50-metre line. Getting there first was Crawford. Trying to dive over the top of the ball there was DeMello. Look at it. It is desperate footy out there at the moment. I'll tell you what, if you win this game today and this is the conditions that stay with us, you're going to have dig very, very deep. You've had to have gone to the well a couple of times, I reckon. Ball towards the boundary line and then eventually out of play. And the player went out there over the boundary line, slowly getting up onto her feet. And that was Stasevich, number 3. Throw in directly in front of us here. Drops in a little short. Ball knocked away. Good play there, O'Hare. Kicks it forward. Chance for Southern Districts here. Kick inside 50. Can they take a mark? No, they can't. Waratah's doing what Southern Districts have done for most of the match. That's defending gamely and desperately. Ball at the 50-metre line. Districts desperate for it. Got the handball away. Can they get a little kick off the ground here? Donna Reed a chance here. Didn't get it. Gathered in this time by Sleeth. Went across towards Thorne. Didn't get it. Thorne's a bit of a chance here. Dives at the footy. Couldn't get it. Went to ground. Ball still there. Tars coming from everywhere. Desperate numbers here. They can't get clear. They try to get clear now. Stasevich. She didn't get it. Little kick under pressure. Gets it out wide outside the defensive 50. Hard running coming in that time was Miller. Ebony Miller, surely not used to playing in wet conditions like this. Ash Manakaris.
No, it's there, diving under. There was Heaney. Healy, she just missed out on a free kick. Play on is the call. Then over the top is Pryor. Sorry, Kate.
No, that's right. It's been a good reset of districts, this rain.
Taylor Thorne swivels around onto her right boot, looking for a teammate. She's found one. Ah, dragged off the play, let go. Umpire just letting it go in these wet conditions, giving everyone an opportunity to get a hold of it. Now he says, give it to me. Charlie, if you look across this half forward line or half back line, districts have set themselves up. This is Tarman Elliott and the way he coaches. So he set up a bit of a wall of districts players to try and keep and lock it in there as Stanley puts it on the boot. But there's Musa, taken high, let go, play on, handball away. Here they go again, the Crocodiles, inside their 50. Sharona Bishop there just taken out. Play on is the call. Still loose. And they can't just seem to get clean possession away.
Desperate footy. You ever played in conditions like this, Katie?
A couple of games. It's a lot of fun, but it's definitely not very clean, that's for sure.
Musa in there working hard. Gee, she's been good. I'm really impressed with her today. Maria Musa, great defender for Southern Districts. 2-3 to 3 points here. We're ticking past the 10-minute mark here of this third term. Big interruption with a massive storm that came in, blew the flags off the flagpoles, kicked to the middle of the ground. Chance here now for Waratah's. Handball back was okay. Got into the hands there of Stanley. Stanley left the footy behind. Desperate work, Crawford got to it. Gave a chance here for Purantata Mary. Got it back towards Nolders, kicking towards the centre of the ground. Districts can get numbers at the fall of the ball. Bella Clark, one of them. You're just forcing this along the ground forward, aren't you? You can't get a decent kick away.
Right. It's like a rolling ball of ruck in rugby union. Sleeth is on their hands and knees there, can't get a hold of it. Now they come out. Chittick was on her hands and knees as well. No one wants to really pick it up. Crawford in there, can't get it. Loose, bumped out there was Crawford coming out the back there. Now there's handballs away. Let's see if there can be a kick somewhere. Chittick's in there for Tars. Still loose, dragged to the ground. Looked like Nolder. No, in fact, that was Collegey, the ruck.
Yeah, I think the key is definitely get it on the boot in conditions like this.
Yeah, I think if you've got space to have three steps, you've got to take that kick.
Yeah.
Here's the ball up out on the wing, front of the Maurice Rioli stand here at TIO Stadium. Lands in the hands of Tars there. They can kick it forward. Might have been Muller. It was a good kick inside 50. Who's there? Mr. Pendable. Terrific. Gets onto her right boot, kicks it high. Tars in front position. Take a strong mark down there. That's Chittick. Amy Chittick. Onto the right boot and she'll kick it inside 50. Oh, that's a terrific mark. They didn't knock it away and she got her hands on that DeMello and she's taken a terrific mark directly out in front. Tough conditions, hard to kick from that distance in these conditions, Katie.
Yeah, most definitely. That ball's going to be pretty heavy. She's lined it up.
Not going to make the distance. Fell short. Tars a chance here. Here's Galt. Tried to get the kick away.
First time it's actually been down the Tars 50 this quarter, isn't it?
No, almost this quarter. That you're right. Mm. Oh, dragged off it was Noel. The great desperation there by the Southern Districts Crocodiles, and a free kick's been paid for holding the ball. Well, they just seem they have lifted their intensity, Districts. Now they did this last week against Palmerston. They came back from I think it was about a 20-point deficit about halfway through the third quarter and ended up winning the game.
So Rhiannon Bush here. She's out on that far side of the ground. TIO Stadium in Darwin. I wouldn't go down the corridor. She's going to go along the boundary line. That's a good kick with
great
a wet ball. Terrific kick. Ball rolls away out in front of Miller. Miller gets to it. Came back into field. Plenty of Tars players there. They can work forward with Muller. Muller's kick towards the boundary line. Chased there by Donna Reed. But they can't get it. And it finishes up in the hands of Lisa Roberts.
Roberts had socket off the ground as they head towards that scoreboard. Scoreboard minus two flags during that brief storm interlude. 13 minutes gone, 2 goals, 3:15, plays 3 points. Flags just blown away in that storm. It's Collegey versus Sleeth. This has been quite the contest today. Sleeth got her hands on her hair with a hurried handball. Alicia Stanley is wrapped up. Starcevic couldn't get clean hands. Collegey goes in to pick it up. Galt's in there as well for Tars. Gee, they're under some pressure, though, from the district's defenders. Can't quite get it out. Nolder on hands and knees. Here it comes. Ball will hug that boundary line. McHugh tries to get the ball away. Stanley gets picked up and wrapped up and thrown to the ground, and the ball's gone out of bounds.
Again, that Shepherd put in there. I think that was Amy Chittick, was it? Put in, and just looking out for each other. That's what these Tars girls do so well.
The boundary ump to throw it in here. We've ticked up to about 14 minutes of this long third term. Tap down with Sleeth. Miller trying to get away with it. And I reckon we've lost our camera coverage of this. And the ball's gone out of play on that far side of the ground.
We'll go back to old school, Charlie. We're back up now.
There we go. It's like magic. Here she is again. The ball off the boot of Lisa Roberts picks up another possession. Big grand final from her. Black screen in front of us again. It's coming on and off. It's got something to do with the weather, I think, if you're watching this somewhere trying to work out what's happening. But a huge storm came through here. And some of the cameras have got water in them. I think they're trying to do some work on them. But there's the score, 2-3 to 3 points here.
Ball is going to be held up on that right half forward for Waratahs. Well, Alicia Stanley not happy. Let the umpire know. Tapped away there. Sleeth again. Starting to get a little bit of dominance. In there is Jeffrey. Hurried kick. Can't quite get a boot properly on it. Still in there. Oh, dropped off it was Collegey. Gee, there's bodies all over that ball. McHugh can't get a hold of it either for Districts. Was wrapped up there as a player and they will ball it up again, Charlie.
Working under some tough conditions here, these players, I can tell you that. Not that easier up in the commentary box either, but we do have some pictures now that we can share with you. Handball was given out there by Healy. He's having a real big game here. Plenty of Southern Districts players at the fall of the ball. They can soccer it forward. Now they've got some space in front of them. They can run to 50, touch it down, get caught in a minute, got the kick away under pressure, down towards the goal line. It'll roll and roll on a dry day. That would have rolled for a goal, but it didn't.
Unlucky.
And the siren brings it to an end.
Oh, they just couldn't quite capitalise on all that play in their forward 50, the Districts. Two goals in it though, anything can happen.
So three-quarter time here, Tars in front, 2-3, Southern Districts 3 points.
She's flying down to Alice today.
Don't forget to put away the garden furniture.
Yep, got it.
And just remember the TIO weather alerts.
Garden furniture!
Love you too.
She's off, but he's still got TIO. They cover you for territory weather. Cyclone, storm surge, flood, hail, and they're local, so they can respond fast.
TIO? Storm staying, kids.
Yeah!
Absolutely zero.
Zero.
Yeah, definitely.
It has to be zero.
Yes.
Yep.
Absolutely.
I don't think that's asking too much.
How does he do it?
24.5 kilowatt diesel motor.
He doesn't just know how to operate every piece of Kennard's high gear we get in, but also its service details, its safety checks. I don't know.
It's as if he can hypnotise each piece.
Give me two passes with sauce, coffee white with one, bun with icing, no pink icing.
Yep, no worries, Terry.
Overrun with rubbish and need a skip bin? For easy disposal from your garden cleanup, renovation or spring clean? When you think skip bins, think NTRS. NTRS, your friendly, reliable and local waste disposal company.
Just Luckily, this rain is starting to die down a little bit, so get a nice comfy spot. A huge 15 minutes of footy here. Districts can still definitely make a comeback. Or will it be Waratah? We'll find out very shortly.
Last time districts beat them, Charlie and Katie, this the scoreline was very tight, wasn't it?
Was. I think that score was 2-7 to 2-2.
So there wasn't much in it last time, and there won't be much in it this time either, as the ball comes over the back centre-half forward. Districts, though, the back six have worked very, very hard today, trying to get it out. Galt, quick handball over the top to a teammate in Stanley. She's been very, very useful all four quarters. Hurried kick, though, loose on the ground. Now they get it away, and they've got the loose player there. Districts can't quite get a hold of it. Now they get out of it over the top. Letitia Jeffrey can't quite get her hands on it, and it gets cleaned up and kicked away.
Now the kick back here, and gave a chance here for Thorne, and Thorne thumps it up for two of the big names down there, Jeffrey and Thorne. But this lady in defence has been superb today, Sharona Bishop. She's stopped every thrust forward there by Southern Districts. Another chance here for them. This is Tessa, Southern Districts. Ball held up, and they get umpire comes in and will ball it up. Wow, Katie Stratter, have you ever seen anything like it? It's a tough old ask at the moment, isn't it?
It is. Low scoring, but still anyone's game. Two quick goals.
Tars win the kick out of the middle, down towards the forward line. It's a bouncing ball. It's giving every chance here to Chittick. She couldn't get to it. The defence got across there quickly through Pemba. And now the little kick is going to work okay. It does. And who do you find? Who else? Moosa. Terrific game from her. Really good game.
She is.
Moosa goes up centre wing, and it's a good... Gee, that's a good mark there. In these conditions, heavy ball, wet fingertip. Good stuff. And a good pass. Picks out her teammate in Bella Clark. Oh, the kick. Grubber, though, not so good. Can't pick it up as Sleeth bending over. Hurried handball away. Now it comes back out. Looking the goods. Hoogan Veenenhill cleaned up, though, by Stanley for Tars.
Just need to settle Tessa here.
Tessa puts it on the boot, punched forward. In there is Pryor for Tars, kicked forward, kicked out of the way. Can't get a hold of it as Miller, smothered off the boot though. Wrapped up there is Martin, hurried handball away. Bishop though, cleaned it up, looking for DeMello. Hip and shoulder is on. Crawford versus DeMello. DeMello goes to kick it, Crawford picks it up. Dragged off the ball, hurried kick away. In comes Poran Tatameri.
Little kick by Poran Tatameri, gets it down in the forward line for Waratahs. Good defensive work there, Sleeth. She's gone the 360 with the footy. Umpire giving them some latitude here. Kick inside 50.
Maddie Gold.
And terrific mark. Gold, she just runs off
done
a player.
It again.
Goes back and kicks forward. Rolls it down in the forward line. It is rolling and it is rolling. They want to kick off the ground, but the wrong boot got to it. and it's thrown out of, pushed out of play. Umpire's going to pick a free kick out of this, I reckon. Was there a holding up?
No.
Holding? No. He's going to get a ball to be thrown in. Deep in the forward pocket here for Tars. One goal and they'll break the heart of Southern District right here. Throw in here, deep in the forward line. 15 points, play three. Pack, snap out of the pack. Ball rolls away, out of play again in front of Amy Chittick.
Yeah, and again, that quick snap from Maddie Galt, picking that up defensively, straight to Sue Nolder.
So throw in here, big pack of players down there in that forward line. Tars know they kick a goal here, the game could be all over. And snap out of the pack again, down towards the goal line. Grabbed there and under real pressure was Purantada Mary, penalised, couldn't get free. Great defensive work back there. Southern District's answering every possible challenge here Tars can throw at them. The kick out went down the corridor, gave Waratah players, two of them, a chance. Desperate play down there by Stanley, who's been outstanding today. Little kick around the body. Oh, they dropped the mark. It was a real chance there for Collegey. Left the ball on the ground. Southern District's under pressure. Back to Taylor Thorne. Runs way and one way and then the other. Gets onto the right boot, pings it out wide outside the 50, dropping back, almost taking the mark was Pryor. Ball lands on the ground, handball away. Southern District's under pressure. Tars with a little kick forward.
Oh,
diving effort to mark is sensational, and a great mark taken back there for Southern District's right on the defensive 50. Nothing much on offer here at the moment, and now they'll go forward. Good kick across that the defensive line. High tackle, umpire lets it go again. Ball goes on the ground. That was good work, Shannon Sharona Bishop. And ball knocked to ground here. Tars under real pressure.
Yeah, it's still loose in there. They're dragging it in, trying to get it out, giving every opportunity. Galt's in there. The umpire says, give it to me. So red and white's lifting their intensity enormously, but District's going with them. Can they get a score, though? That's the challenge. Three Tars players get on it. In there is Collegey, the ruck. She can't get it out. In there is Sleeth as well. Musa. All names we've called repeatedly today. Desperation getting towards the end. 5.5 minutes gone here in this final term. Premiership medal up for grabs. Kicked into the Tars. DeMello trying to lead the race for the Waratahs team. It comes out the back quick hands. Here comes Healy. She's had pace early. Left foot. Didn't quite balance, couldn't quite get it away, and the ball will go out of bounds.
Great effort. And earlier today we had the under-18 women's or the girls' grand final, Charlie. The results of that, they were playing over on TIO2.
And Buffett's won 8-8 to 6-4 against Palmerston. 16-point winners. Well done to the Buffett's team. Grand final for them. That was a chance there to seal the grand final for Tars. It didn't happen. Ball went away. Throw in deep in that forward pocket. Handball comes out now. Good work in defence. Four Southern Districts. Ball left on the ground. They've got players getting there. They're on top at the moment, I reckon, Southern Districts. And the mark was good, taken back there in defence by Sleeth. She was caught, had to give the handball away. Purantada Mary looking dangerous in this sort of weather. Handball comes out. Tars from a long way out, go down to the goal line. Good mark back there in defence. Ebony Miller. Wow, how good's she been?
Yeah.
Up from Alice Springs. Pinktails player. Daughter of the great Chippy, got onto the right boot, kicks it out long. She kicks like Chippy as well, 60 metres. Beautiful kick. Out wide towards that 50-metre line. Tars with the handball given out there by Lisa Roberts, who's been good today. Kick under pressure. Chance there for Purantada Mary. Pack comes over the top. No one can get clear. A little hurried kick came out, goes along the boundary line. Crawford gets there. Onto the right boot she goes. Kicks it up towards 50. Good kick too. Chance there for Hannah to get to it. Didn't get it. Tars get just half a kick away. Along the boundary line they go. It's right along the boundary line. They manage to keep it in. Can they keep it in long enough? Miller with a handball, gave it out to Sleeth. Sleeth, oh, they nearly got to her. She got the kick away under pressure. Down towards the 50-metre line. Little handball that didn't find the target. Left behind. Desperate play out there, Ashley Manikaris. Absolutely desperate.
No one can get clean possession in slippery conditions as they try to now. The handball, the task is just to keep it moving forward. No one's prepared to quite pick it up. Stanley says, I will, and then puts it long inside. Chittick off her chest, can't quite get a hold of it. McHugh doesn't worry about trying to pick it up. That's a throw. Play on is the call. In there is Collegey. She can't get a clean kick away. Everyone dives on it. Now it comes out the back still. Now they'll try and ease some of the pressure. And they do. McHugh gets, puts it on the boot. Centering kick, though, back into the middle. Letitia Jeffrey on her right foot. Taylor Thorne doesn't, can't pick it up. Sockers it off herself as the runners and water girls, or carriers, are trying to get out of the way. Thorne keeps it in front. One-handed pickup. Beautiful pickup in these conditions. Then puts it on the right boot. Just wants it out in front of a teammate, though. Can't quite get there. Thorne following up her own kick. Does all the work. It's two versus two. Districts, though, get out of trouble. Good Shepherd there.
Tars equal to the task. They did really well. Got it up towards the wing. They have the extra players back here. Sutton Districts under pressure was good. They heard the voice. They can go from the wing. It was a kick forward there by Patterson. Down towards, almost towards a half forward line. In the way, Maddie Galt kicks it over the top. Plenty of Districts players back there. Dropping back and using the handball pretty well was Miller. Ball still there for Tars. If they can get their hands on it, they can't. They've got a number of players back there. Collegey, one of them. She reaches from the back. Collegey, she can't get. She's gone over the top of Patterson as the umpire picked it up. Oh, my goodness.
Very unlucky.
Wow. That was unsighted and unlucky.
Tapped over. They're still trying to keep the pressure on. Well, the ball just bounces out. And will be thrown in, and not for the first time today. 9 3/4 minutes gone here in the final term. 2-3, 3 points, and the clock ticking down, and the game getting away from the Crocodiles. Burrentata Mary couldn't quite get a hold of it. Tunnel ball, trying to get it out. And it's a quick kick off the ground. Stanley trying to get it out for Tars. Collegey's in there as well, still loose. Miller. Use of the body, drags Purantata Mary off the ball. Chittick dodges one, can't beat two though. Going in there to try and pick it up with Stasevich, thrown and flung down. We'll get a free kick for her troubles. Gets up with a limp. What do you think about some of that desperation,
Katie? Tough. It is. It's desperation, exactly what it is. There's only 5 minutes left, a little bit over.
Yeah, and the premiership coming up for Waratah, you would think, is Stanley touch ball. And they get it away, Crocodiles.
Kick out towards the wing. Tars in front position out here. Lisa Roberts kicks it inside 50. Dropping back, taking a strong mark back there was Clark, Bella Clark. So the clock the enemy here for Southern Districts. You just get the feeling, Katie, if they kick a goal, it will
exactly,
just fire them up.
Exactly, that's all I'm thinking. Yeah. The adrenaline's pumping. I can't imagine what's going through their head.
And Tars know it as well. They're just not going to make it easy for them. It's desperate to get a possession out here. Ball underneath all of those players, going down with it all on top of her was Muller. Comes out and lands in the hand somehow of Collegey. Has worked very hard today. Collegey with the ball in her hand, can't break the tackle. Umpire says, give it to me and we'll ball it up.
As Districts say, the minute they get it out, they're just shut down.
Oh, one out by Collegey there. That's important win. That's an important win in this in these conditions. The kick was smothered by Galt there, our teammate. Now it comes over the top. They come through there. Stanley again. I've called her name a few times today. Gee, she's been good. Musa, another one that's been called repeatedly. Letitia Jeffrey from Districts gets it. Gives it to a teammate, and the teammate puts it on the boot, and that's Clark. Loose, though. There's Sharona Bishop. She has been super reliable across that halfback flank for Waratahs, and wrapped up, though, by another good player today, which is Sleeth. Sleeth for the Crocodiles. Puts it straight on the boot. She's got two options.
Goes out wide there, hoping to get it to Patterson. She got to it, but couldn't wrap it up. Tars equal to the task with a kick out towards the wing. Runners come everywhere, lots of them wearing the red and white. Thump kick forward down towards the half forward line. It's a foot race, running hard for it. Bree Martin, will she get to it? She's still a bit of a chance here. Bree Martin looking for it, going down looking for it. She couldn't get it. Good work, Southern Districts in defence. Kick across that half back line. Purantata Mary, a bit of a chance here. Trying to break the tackle out there was Clark. Got it to set a half back. Giving Musa a bit of a chance here. Musa from the back gets there. Couldn't get it, though. Good work, Healy, who's been good today, Healy. A little kick out towards the half-forward line. Southern Districts back there in defence. They can get clear. Can they? No, they can't. They've left it behind. Tried to kick it off the ground. Out there was McHugh. Glenn's in the hands of Purantata Mary. Tried to get clear. Grab it, a kick across the centre-half back. All Southern Districts here. They can run away from centre-half back. They've got to hit a target. They didn't. They got it to the middle of the ground. Two on two here. Who's more desperate for it? Southern District's under real pressure. They got half clear. Couldn't get a good kick away. Clark came in looking for it. Stolen this time by Bella Clark. Inside 50. Ball gets clear. Out in front of Cooper. Cooper took a little bit of a look, then ran free with it. Terrific defensive work by the Red and Whites. They set it out towards the boundary line.
And Pippa Cox has got time on her hands, picks it up, then sends it back in board looking for Collegey. Collegey and Sleeth go at it. Comes off Collegey's hands, can't quite pick it up. Coming through there was Holtz. Holtz gives it off to a teammate in Sleeth. Still loose. Sleeth wants to pick it up. Hip and shoulder there. Dodging around, though, is DeMello. Had a handy game today across half forward. DeMello on the boot. Picking it up, though, is Chittick. Chittick from 50 out. Bouncing ball will bounce across the face of goal, and then will stop. Bree Martin will get in there. Bumped off it there. Great hip and shoulder from Miller. Miller gives it off to her teammate, who then fumbles it first time, but recovers quick enough to give it a tittered on the boot, but it's boiled, and Chittick. Chittick with a quick hands, but it's chopped off in the goal square by Deegan.
Oh, they've been terrific in defence. Here's Patterson. Take a bow, those defenders back there for Southern Districts. They've been amazing today. Kept Tars down to just a couple of goals. Here's the left foot kick. They just can't get it down in the forward line, Southern Districts. They want it there desperately. Rapson Staropoli. Steadies it down. And why not? 14 and a half minutes gone. That's what you do, wouldn't you, Katie?
That's right. Smart play. Freeze the game.
Luce McHugh has got first use of the ball. Oh, and there's a sling off the ball, but it's let go. Musa should try and pick it up. No, coming through was Roberts, I thought. Ball's going to be dived on. Chittick's in there as well. Be wrapped up, be balled up about 48 metres out, 45 degree. Great field position for Waratahs. District's under pressure. One out, though, by Sleeth. Hurried kick. Musa in there. Oh, just that slippery ball. Can't quite get clean possession. Come outsiding, outside the 50. Spinning around, looking for a target in board, and finds Galt.
Maddie
Galt. She's got options. Decides to play on. Smothered off the boot, though, by Thorne. Regathers from 30 out. Goes Goldwood. Nolga lets it bounce through. And on the siren it goes, and Waratahs have won this grand final. 3-3 to Southern District's 3 points.
we do a lot of
If we could please ask for both the Waratahs and the Southern Districts to make your way over to the presentation area, please. The captain of the Waratahs, Lisa Robert.
Hello.
And last, our
Thank you.